Hey, what's happening, brewskis? I'm your host, the Super Corn You Drank Dude, as always, and my friend...
Legendary C4...
Corey Redden.
Yes, sir.
And, hey, Corey, how was your week?
Pretty good. Good 4th of July.
You had a really good 4th of July week, but you notice, guys, Jurassic World is out.
Yes.
And Dominion was an awesome movie. And in honor of that movie, I thought I'd do something a little different and creative today. And, by the way, we have these figures here, and a couple of new Mountain Dew Energy Drink, Mountain Dew Energy. They changed the name from Rise to Energy.
Got Cherry Lime Lift
and Baja Blast.
Yeah.
So we've been wanting to try these out for you guys.
Should we do the Baja Blast first?
We're gonna actually. I take that back. Let's try out the Cherry Lime Lift. I got the red bandana after all. I have a very good feeling about this Cherry Lime Lift.
All right.
For me, bro.
It's a slow roll, but it's rising up. Oh yeah, this is really smells great.
It does smell good.
It smells fantastic.
These are essential for now because I remember when we did the last video on the Mountain Dew Rise. Mm. These weren't out yet, guys.
Nope. We didn't have this one. So this is caffeine equal to 2 cups of coffee per can, 5% juice, 0 sugar added, zinc and vitamins A and C.
That is a nice cherry lime flavor.
I like it.
If you're a fan of cherry lime, man,
it's 180 milligrams of caffeine.
Hey, sure. That's all you need.
Punch.
That's a couple of cups of coffee. And I'd have to give it, man. This has exceeded my expectations. I'm
gonna
have to pour another glass.
Oh shit. Man's gonna pour him another glass.
It's a nice cherry flavor.
Check it.
Check it out. Filled with antioxidants that will knock you out.
Feeling refreshed.
Well, absolutely. This is a good drink in time for the summer, guys.
I think it's perfect for a good early morning drink, or afternoon, wherever. Times for you to drink one, but I personally picked me one up to go to work in the morning.
And I know these have been out for a
while.
They are definitely a good wake-up call. And in spite of it all, these have been out, I know, for a while, maybe the last several months or so, bro, but I've been wanting to jump on these as soon as I can get to them, and, with the way work schedule is and things. Y'all understand that. But, we're advertising the Jurassic World. We have our shirts on, and we have these cool last dinosaurs. And I'm recommending checking it out. It was a really good movie.
Yeah, I liked it. It was really, really, really super good movie.
It exceeded my expectations, man. I thought it was super cool.
For a dinosaur movie, I mean, you get your action. It could have used a little bit more action, but it was still a very good movie.
Yeah.
For to end the trilogy.
Yeah, well, tell them your thoughts, Corey, what you believe could have helped that movie out in a major way.
Maybe like more gigafights with that other dinosaur that had the claws, the Therizino.
Yeah.
Like, that one would have been cool to see him more often.
Yeah, it should have been extended a lot longer.
Now, the raptor scene was great.
Mm-hmm.
On the bike chase.
No complaints.
That was long, too.
And Chris Pratt, one of my favorite actors in our decade. And, I mean, he's pulling out the stops when it comes to making blockbuster hits like The Guardians of the Galaxy and so many of the other movies that he's been credited to. But, dude, yeah, I have to overall say about this Jurassic World, I should say, Dominion, the third in caliber, they really succeeded in what I didn't know what to expect going into this movie, and I was floored. I was in awe. I was excited about the collaboration from both worlds, how they all came together from the Jurassic Park original trilogy, and they all met in this third movie. So I thought they did an outstanding job. I have to give it a rating of overall. I think I'm going to give it right up there. I think I'm going to give it a 10.
You're
going to
give it
a
10? Okay. It's a good movie.
It was a win for me. And my buddy here, he gives it 1.
I'm going to give it a 9.
Yeah. That's a strong one for that one, John. So that's the only reason why I'm giving it a 10, because, it by far exceeded my expectations as far as bringing everybody together.
It is what it's supposed to be. It's mainly for, kids antidotes too, but like, you know, it's a kid's targetable movie. Like, you know, it had the dinosaurs that needed. They just should have been a little bit longer. I think the story was pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think they ended it on a bad note.
No.
I would like to see a series. What do you guys think? If they should do a series?
They should do a series. They actually have a Jurassic Park one, but it's a cartoon. I'd rather see like a live action one.
Yeah. If you guys agree with us, feel free to write it down in the comments below if you like this video. And we're going to continue on with the next one. Ready, I'm pumped, super pumped about this one. Baja Blast. Now, we all know the reputation that Baja Blast has. You can find these at Taco Bell originally. Of course, Mountain Dew has had variations of Baja Blast. They got the Baja Blast Zero as well as the original. And then, you know, of course, you can get them in the fountain at Taco Bell. But I've never had Mountain Dew Energy.
No, this one's new. So it's new to us.
And I love the green can.
It's a nice tint. It's a mental boost.
All right, man. So what do you give this rating of the Cherry Lime Lift?
I'm going to give it, I mean, I like it. I wish it had real sugar in it. I mean, I like the zero sugar aspect of it, but I think it would taste better with real sugar. But just as it is, I'm gonna give it an 8. I think it's a pretty solid drink. I just take 2 points off for not having a sugar version.
Yeah.
If they had a sugar version with more carbonation, that would be perfect.
Yeah. Well, they
it's still good.
They've done a really good job with Mountain Dew Energy, in spite of the fact that they did have to change their name, unfortunately.
I mean, at least it doesn't taste like Code Red. I mean, everything it tastes. It's got its own unique like flavor. I mean, it has a little Code Red esque to it, but it's not like Code Red. It's got a different taste.
Yeah. And I mean, you can't go wrong with a mental boost.
Need some more.
I mean, there's all kinds of nice vitamins in this that helps you get pumped throughout the day. All right, man. Well, I'm not going to waste any more time or any delay, and I'm going to open up this Mountain Dew Energy. Baja Blast. Spilling.
Yeah.
See the color? It looks just like regular Baja Blast. Same as always. Nothing different.
Nothing to see.
But it does have
everything to taste and smell.
Fizziness. Top. Smells like Baja Blast.
Now.
So we're more energized, though.
Honestly, I think this is better than the Cherry Lime Lift.
You think so, bro?
Honestly, I think it's just like, Cherry Lime Lift's not bad, don't get me wrong, but like, I think this is it.
It's got a nice, they all have that same kind of caffeine sting anticipation that you would get with 2 cups of coffee, you know what I mean? So it's blended on the same foundation of what they use as far as
the same product, just different tastes, you know,
different flavor.
They got the same amount of vitamins and caffeine and all that stuff. It's all the same. But good thing is, if you're on a diet and you know you're not trying to take in sugar, this is, you know, it's got 4 total sugars but no added sugar, and it's 25 calories, which is, you know, if you're trying to get fit and you still want that sweet taste and something to give you a boost, this is it.
You want to get fit and stay proactive, this is the way to do it.
Not saying it's healthy for you, but it's a better option than going and getting yourself a normal Red Bull or Monster that are just, well, have 60 grams of sugar.
It's a nice tropical lime blend, just like the Baja Blast that you find in stores, man, but it's got a little bit more extra pep.
And I'm not a big fan of Monsters, but this one, I'd pick this up over Monster any day, just my personal opinion.
Yeah, that's definitely.
They're loaded with sugar, and the sugar kind of, they overdo it in the Monster.
Yeah, right. And if you're not careful, too much sugar can really, like, bring your body down.
Yeah, and you get this tire.
You're tired, and you're not in the game. So, what good is that if you're not, you know, in your A game?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, dude, I'm thrilled that they have this out as one of their selections with Mountain Dew Energy. It's definitely a plus in my opinion. just stating the facts, man. There's a lot of good stuff. There's plenty of things in them. So you can't go wrong with low sugar. And sodium is 170 milligrams.
Yep.
Zero fat. So what I think about that, dude, I'm gonna give this. I think I didn't give you a rating of the cherry lime mix. I'm gonna give it a 9.
I gave it an 8.
And with the Baja Energy, Baja Blast, I'm gonna probably give this a 9.5.
I think I'm gonna do the same.
I like it a little bit higher than the cherry lime lift, just because I like the fact that Mountain Dew decided that one of their favorite top flavors that in Taco Bell and out there as far as one of the top sellers for Baja drinks, that these now exist. Now I wonder if they'll do a Baja Mango Gym Energy or a Baja Flash. If they should happen to bring that pineapple coconut flavor back from the past.
Yeah.
So now I've changed my bandana and to match the flavor of what I like the best. And that is this Mountain Dew Energy Baja Blast. Remember to always stay true, be cool in everything you do. And this is your pal and your homie, Legendary C4.
Yep.
Saying peace.